Good evening, Shapers. I'm so excited just to spend another amazing Engage Culture moment, Engage Culture podcast with every one of you. And I've got an interesting concept, an interesting idea that I want to share with you. First and foremost, I want to thank every one of you just for the love you've been showing us, showing up for all these sessions, downloading the podcast on Apple and Spotify. Make sure you subscribe to the Engage Culture podcast. Okay, let's do this. Okay, today's concept came when I was doing just some spring cleaning in my study. And I came across something which I believe if I'm going to show my children this in a couple of years' time, they're going to look at me and say, "Dad, we don't know what this is." I found my Avengers box set, and it got me to think about just the rise of the Marvel Cinematic Universe. And as we open this, I'll show you a couple of things. All right. The Marvel Cinematic Universe actually began in the year 2008 with an obscure character, an obscure movie, with an obscure superhero by the name of Iron Man. And in fact, the year before that, the first Marvel Cinematic movie which was released was actually The Incredible Hulk. It didn't do so well. And in the following year, they invested $140 million to start the Marvel Cinematic Universe with Iron Man. And they put $140 million and they made a modest $500 million from the box office. And it was off to a slow start. And you got to understand that when they launched the Marvel Cinematic Universe in 2007, 2008, Iron Man was not as big as he was today. Back then, there was the big three. The big three superheroes of that time were actually Superman, Batman, and Spider-Man. Those were the three biggest superheroes from the time that they were incepted in the comics, in the 30s and in the 60s, in the case of Spider-Man. Batman and Superman were created in the 1930s. And these are like the biggest superheroes. So by the time there was an Iron Man movie in 2008, no one really knew anything about Iron Man, and it wasn't projected to do well. And it's interesting how sometimes people have a way of projecting failure in your life, and they don't even know what God is about to do through you and through your ministry and through your life. So when this movie came out, people had no idea that beneath the surface there was a visionary. There was a visionary by the name of Kevin Feige. And Kevin Feige had a vision to create what is known as the Marvel Cinematic Universe. And this is an interconnected universe of movies where all the superheroes have singular movies and then they combine at the end of a cycle to form the Avengers. Yes, and let me take my Avengers thing here. The Avengers. And what would happen is, this was something which had never been done before. Many times, a Superman movie would just be about Superman and would not be connected to a Batman movie or to a Green Lantern movie, to any other movie. It was always self-contained. But for the first time in Hollywood history, these movies were being created with the intention of forming this team-up movie called The Avengers. And when The Avengers dropped in 2012, the first Avengers movie, it broke box office records and it made $1 billion. It was the first time for there to be a billion-dollar grossing comic book hero franchise. And then all of this work which Kevin Feige did climaxed with what is known as the Avengers Endgame in the year 2019, just before the drama. In the year 2019, Avengers Endgame was dropped after Avengers Infinity War, which was absolutely amazing. When that movie dropped, it actually broke the record, which was held by Titanic, to be the highest grossing movie of all time. At it made above $2.7 billion, close to $2.8 billion, and that's in a 10-year span they were able to make the biggest movie of all time. And all the movies combined have made billions of dollars. This is the most successful Hollywood cinematic property. It is an incredible testimony of one thing which I want to share today, which is vision. Proverbs 29 verse 18 says, where there is no vision, the people perish. The most important thing in your life is to have a vision. You've got to have a clear idea of where you are going. And vision, what is vision? Vision is just basically your concept or your idea of the future and what it is that you want to become. It is very important that you have vision. Without vision, people perish. Without vision, families perish. Without vision, relationships perish. Don't hook up with somebody who is handsome, beautiful, whatever, but they don't have a vision. It is critical that you make sure that when you connect with someone, the first question is, where are we going? Where is this thing going? That's the most important thing. And without vision, relationships perish. Without vision, families break down. It's so important that if you are married, it's so important if you're a parent, that you've got to have a family vision. You've got to have something which you are working towards and working to achieve. Because without vision, families perish. Without vision, cities perish. Without vision, nations perish. When you look at nations, any nation that is struggling, any nation that is not doing well economically, that's not doing well in terms of development, it all comes down to, what is the vision? What is the vision for South Africa? What is the vision of our fellow African brother state nations and brothers and sister nations? What is the vision that is going to take us from being underdeveloped countries to being developed countries? What is the vision? Without vision, anything perishes. And it's very important to understand that. So with vision, then, with vision, people thrive. With vision, people grow. With vision, people become great. So you might be under attack. You might be facing challenges. You might be going through various things. But as long as you've got a vision, you are going to rise and you are going to make it. And one of the key components of vision then has got to be the patience to build the right foundation. And I really want to talk about foundation for a few seconds, because many times what we've got in this generation, in this social media generation, is we've got a whole bunch of people who are all about image and sharing these elaborate social media pictures. I mean, if you go on Instagram, everybody, you think there's no pandemic. You think that nobody gets sick. You think that nobody gets in debt. You think that no one is getting fired. You think that everything is happening so well. And it is such, there's just so much fakery on Instagram. You know, some people, even the way they smile, if you look carefully, you can see that behind that smile, there are tears. And a lot of people, there's a lot of fake stuff that's happening on social media streets. And it's sad if you now use social media to beat yourself down and feel bad about your life. Behind a lot of those pictures, some of those pictures, most of those pictures, there's a lot of pain, there's a lot of struggle, the same struggles you're facing, the same difficulties you're facing, a lot of people are going through them. But what happens is, because of this concept of fake it till you make it, a lot of people have this thing where they have a lot of image, but they have nothing. They have a lot of public image, but they have nothing in private that they are developing, nothing in private that they are building. It's very important that you build whatever it is you're building on a firm foundation of mastery, on a firm foundation of competence, on a firm foundation of excellence, on a firm foundation of integrity. It's very important that we have to be the kind of people who specialize in having victory in a private space. We've got to have something we're working on, a craft, a skill, a gift, a ministry, a career, and it's all developed in secret. We don't become great through our social media posts. We become great by the value we add to people's life through a skill that is useful in the context of whatever environment you are in. And I just want to encourage every one of you, build patient. Be patient in the season of obscurity. When you're dealing in, when you're dealing with a season of obscurity, be patient with developing your craft. Be patient with developing your life. Be patient with developing your career. And I think one of the most important messages we shared in this podcast, if you haven't watched it or if you haven't listened to it, I want to encourage you right now. It was called Career Guidance. Career Guidance. And it is so important that you always answer this question. What is your occupation? What do you do? What do you do? And what value do you add? And you must always make sure that you're expanding that, getting better in that, and increasing that capacity, because that is what's going to make you great. You've got to have vision, and you've got to have a skill that you're developing. It's got to be built on the foundation of a skill that you're developing in secret when nobody else is watching, when everybody else has written you off. You're there, you're developing a skill, you're developing a craft, and you're working on something in secret. I want to encourage you to join the ministry of moving low-key. I want to encourage, in this culture where everybody, I mean, sometimes there's oversharing that is happening on social media. I want to encourage you to join the ministry of moving low-key, the ministry of not being bothered by what other people are posting, but your concern is becoming better as a person, becoming better as a human being, becoming better in your craft, becoming better in the skill that you provide in the marketplace to generate whatever income or whatever revenue that you have for you and your family. I want to encourage you to move in low key and get better in secret. And that's also for some of these people in my church who are just posting these pictures. Oh, I've run 10 kilometers. I'm making us feel bad in these streets. Some of us, we're working out in secret. Don't worry, you're just going to see when summer comes, there'll be some transformation. But I would encourage you, I'm messing with the health guys in church. Keep posting, it keeps us encouraged and inspired. But I want to encourage every one of you, find something you're going to develop in secret. And then in 2 or 3 years time, you're just going to post, boom, graduated, master's, PhD. Boom, I've just opened the store. Boom, I've just, whatever it is, develop something in secret and let God promote you in public. I pray that God blesses you. Without vision, people perish. Write the vision, make it plain, work on it in secret and trust God and believe that it's going to come to pass. I love you and I appreciate you. God is with us. Great things are coming. We're engaging culture and we are going to transform it.